This video is designed for faculty members who are new to D2L 10.3, particularly those upgrading from version 10.0 or earlier. In the next several minutes, we're going to take a look at the newly redesigned content area within D2L 10.3 and demonstrate how to add files and information into this new format. The first thing you're probably going to notice when you look at content in a newly converted course as a faculty member is that your content is not immediately visible. When you first click on content, it may look like this, a blank screen, but don't worry, your files and links are still there. What you're seeing is the new overview page that is now included in the content area. If you choose to use this page, you may want to think of it as a start point for the course. I would recommend possibly adding your syllabus to this page or including some basic course and contact information. Here's a very simple example of what you might do with the overview page. Though the possibilities are wide open, you could include links, embed videos, PDFs, or whatever info you choose. Notice that if I want to edit the information that I have here, all I need to do as an instructor is click in the overview area, and I can begin to edit in the HTML editor window. You might have also noticed that I said if you choose to use this overview page, because you certainly don't have to use it. If you don't want to add an overview page for your course, you can simply navigate straight to the table of contents, which is found right here. D2L will remember where you left the content area once you exit the course, and the next time you log in, you should bypass that empty overview altogether. Also, if the overview area is left blank by the instructor, your students will never see it, so you don't have to worry about students being confused by a blank-looking page in D2L. Now that we've looked at the overview page, let's take a closer look at this table of contents. I access the full table of contents by clicking here at the top of this course panel. I can also access an individual module within the table of contents by clicking its corresponding button in the same panel. In this sample course, I've created one module for each week. But you may have a module for each type of content in your course, or you can use any other module organization method you choose. Within each module, then, I can have all sorts of course content, including the following. First, files I upload from my computer, like PDFs or PowerPoints. Here's an example of a PowerPoint loaded into a course. Notice what happens when I click on the PowerPoint. Because D2L 10.3 has its own PowerPoint reader, I can view this PowerPoint right here in D2L without having to download it, though I can download it onto my computer so that I can print it or save it or view it offline by clicking this download button. When I open the PowerPoint, though, you'll notice that I lose the course outline panel, but don't worry, I can still navigate around the content area of my course either by using this breadcrumb chain at the top of the screen. See here, I can click here to return back to week one or here to return to the full table of contents, or I can click on the course pop-out outline menu, which is located here. This allows me to go to any particular item within week one, or I can click on this link to return to the table of contents. Notice that I also have arrow buttons that let me move to the next item or the previous item in the content area if I choose. Right now I'm going to go back to the table of contents. Now, in addition to those uploaded files, I can also view and have files that I've created within D2L. You can think of these like word processing or Google Doc files that are built right inside D2L. Here's an example of one of those. If I want to edit this file as an instructor, I simply click Edit HTML, and here I can change the text, add image, add video, do anything that is possible within the HTML editor. Going back again to the table of contents, this time I'll use the breadcrumb chain, I see that I can also include links within content to any other type of D2L tool, including Dropbox, quizzes, and discussion boards. I could even create these items right here in content if I choose. Make sure you check out the New and Add Existing Activities menus in the content area to discover all the various things that can now be included and created right within content. To add any of these items, you simply select them from these menus and follow the prompts given. Now, to add a new module, it's a slightly different process. To do that, I simply go to the module list and I start clicking and typing in this bottom box where it says Add a Module. Here, I'll add a Week 12 module just to show you how that works. One other thing I want to point out about the new D2L content interface is the drag and drop functionality. Within D2L, you can now drag items or modules into a different order. To do it, you just hover your mouse over the faint triple hash mark until your mouse turns into crossed arrows, and then you can click and drag from there. You can click and drag items within a module, or you can even move them to another module if you choose. You can also drag files into D2L directly from your computer with most internet browsers. Now, in addition to the big picture format changes I've covered in this video, there are many other little improvements and feature additions that have been added into the content area. I'll be putting out more videos on these, so keep an eye out on the YouTube channel in this playlist, and feel free to reach out to me if you have any other questions about D2L 10.3.